Was she just the devil with venomous snakes on her head, or the woman who was being a victim of man's exploitation and desire, or the personification of women's rage? Who really was Medusa? Hello there, welcome to the Freak Day Friday. Today we'll talk about the snake head monster, Medusa. So let's begin with it. In Greek mythology, Medusa was one of the three sisters of Gorgons, the daughter of Ceto and Phorcys. She was the only mortal Gorgon. By the way, who were these Gorgons? Gorgon occur in the earliest example of Greek literature. While description of Gorgons vary, the term most commonly referred to the three sisters, they are described as winged human females with living venomous snake in place of hair. Those who gazed into her eyes would petrify, that is, he would turn into a stone. Traditionally, two of the Gorgons, Steno and Uriel, were immortal. Just you have to know that Gorgons were terrible monsters, really vicious. In most versions of story, Medusa was beheaded by the hero Perseus, the son of Zeus and Danae, who was sent to fetch her head by King Polydectes of Seriphus. He received a mirrored shield from Aetna, sandals with gold wings from Hermes, a sword from Hephaestus, and Hades' helm of invisibility. Since Medusa was the only one of the three Gorgons who was mortal, Perseus was able to slay her while looking at the reflection from the mirrored shield. It was given to goddess Aetna to place the head on her shield. But was she always been a monster?
No.
In the late version of Medusa myth by the Roman poet Ovid, he described Medusa as a beautiful maiden. She was not always a monster. She was originally a ravishingly beautiful maiden, priestess in the Aetna's temple. But when she was caught being sexually assaulted by the lord of the sea, Poseidon, in Aetna's temple, Minerva, the enraged war goddess Aetna transformed Medusa's beautiful hair to a serpent and made her face so terrible to behold that the mere sight of it would turn onlookers to stone. So, according to Ovid, she was a victim of men's desire and exploitation. But not all think the same way. For Sigmund Freud, the decapitation of Medusa, he related it with castration. But soon, in mid-20th century, feminists reassessed Medusa's appearance in literature and in modern culture. Medusa's visage has since been adopted by many women as a symbol of female rage. For many, she can be a map to guide us through our terrors, through the depth of our anger, into the sources of our power as women, as said by Froggy Lupton. Even in contemporary pop culture, Medusa has become largely synonymous with feminine rage. Through many of her iterations, Medusa pushes back against a story that seeks to place the male Perseus at its center, blameless and heroic. Author Sibyl Bombach described Medusa as a multimodal image of intoxication, petrification, and luring attractiveness, citing her seductive contemporary representation as well as her dimensionality as the reason for her longevity. According to Elizabeth Johnston, a feminist, she says, "In the Western culture, strong women have historically been imagined as a threat requiring male conquest and control, and Medusa herself has long been the go-to figure for those seeking to demonize female authority." For others, like Percy Bysshe Shelley, he describes in a poem Medusa as a beautiful young woman. Stephen Wilk, author of Medusa: Solving the Mystery of the Gorgon, questioned Medusa's enduring status among the feminist movement. He believes that one reason for her longevity may be her role as a protector, fearsome and enraged. Only the Gorgon have the savage, threatening appearance to serve as an immediately recognized symbol of rage and protector of women's secret, wrote Welk. So for him, she was a protector. According to the name of Medusa, Medusa means protector. So I guess he was right. Medusa's story has also been interpreted in contemporary art and classic cases of sexual assaulted victim blaming by the goddess Aetna. Inspired by the Me Too movement, contemporary figurative artist Judy Tecas returns Medusa's beauty along with the hashtag MeDusaToo. Feminist theorist Helen Sisix famously tackled the myth of Medusa in her essay, The Laugh of the Medusa. She says, "You only have to look at the Medusa straight on to see her, and she is not deadly. She is beautiful and she is laughing." So whatever you think about her, Medusa has always been there in her culture, in the myths, in the form of art, pictures, paintings, in the movies, series, and variety of things. She always laid her eye on us. So it's all upon you how you see her. See her as a villain with the snakes on her head who petrifies just by looking at her, or as a pretty, beautiful woman who is strong enough to defy this authoritative world of men.